Welcome to Sports Illustrated's Experts Corner. I'm Seth Davis with a look ahead to the NCAA tournament. I thought for much of the season that the Big Ten was probably going to get two number one seeds in the NCAA tournament. Now I'm kind of feeling like it's a little bit less likely. Outside of Indiana, I think the only Big Ten team that is positioned to potentially get a number one would be Michigan State, but they're going to have to win the Big Ten conference tournament, which is obviously not going to be very easy to do. You just have a lot of other strong candidates around the country. I'm looking at New Mexico, potentially out of the Mountain West, Georgetown, Kansas, Florida, Duke or Miami in the ACC. There are just too many good teams in position to get a number one seed for me to believe that it's going to happen out of the Big Ten. However, if any conference in America is going to get two number one seeds, the Big Ten is certainly going to be the most likely. Just too many candidates, too few spots for me to believe that it's really going to happen. If Gonzaga finishes the season strong and wins the West Coast Conference Tournament, it will be in a very good position for a number one seed. However, it will also be in a precarious position for a number one seed. Why do I say that? If you stipulate that Indiana is going to be a number one pretty much regardless of what happens from here on out, you have various teams out there who will have a strong, probably a stronger case for Gonzaga if they take care of business. For example, Georgetown. If Georgetown wins the Big East regular season title and wins the Big East tournament, they'll have a stronger claim to a number one seed than Gonzaga. Duke or Miami, whichever team of those two wins the ACC tournament, playing a tougher schedule, I think they would have a stronger claim. And then also Kansas in the Big 12. If they win the Big 12 regular season and the Big 12 tournament, then I think they would be ahead of Gonzaga on the seed line, and maybe another wild card from the Big 10 as well, perhaps Michigan State should they win the Big 10 tournament. So Gonzaga has done all that it can do. Mark Few put together a great non-conference schedule. They took care of business, but their league just doesn't help them as much as the other leagues help their potential champion. So those are a lot of ifs on the board. Gonzaga is in good position, but it could slide if those other teams take care of business. In a season like this one, where there's been a lot of parity, a lot of top-ranked teams losing on a regular basis, this is the year to really look for Cinderellas. I start in the Mid-American Conference with the Akron Zips. This team at one point had won 18 games in a row, completely dominated this league at home and on the road. It is an experienced team with a lot of juniors and seniors, a steady point guard in Alex Abreu, a strong, tough glue guy, power forward in Demetrius Treadwell, and one of the best-kept secrets in America, the premier shot blocker, 7-foot senior center, Zeke Marshall. Akron's won a lot of games, and I think that that becomes a habit that will serve them well in the NCAA tournament. Another team that I have my eye on is Belmont. Rick Bird's team has a lot of NCAA tournament experience. They've been there the last couple of years. They're really fun to watch. They're small. They spread the floor. They shoot a lot of three-pointers. One of the best scoring guards in the history of the school in Ian Clark. I think whoever they play in the NCAA tournament, Belmont will be able to put a scare into that team. And then finally, St. Louis out of the Atlantic 10 just entered the rankings. We all know the storyline. Rick Majerus passed away before the season started. This is a very experienced team. Not a lot of great players. They beat you with their toughness. They beat you with their depth. They take care of the ball. They've got all players who are in their early 20s, and I think that's a big-time advantage in the NCAA tournament. St. Louis is ready to do some damage. My surprise team this season is Georgetown. The Hoyas did have some expectations coming into the season, but it looked pretty dire when midway through the Big East season they lost Greg Whittington. He's a forward who was their second leading scorer and rebounder, and he was declared academically ineligible for the rest of the season. I knew that Otto Porter was a very good player. I certainly did not anticipate that he would be arguably the best player in the country, maybe a front runner for National Player of the Year, and now Georgetown has emerged as the best team in the Big East Conference, and they're going to be a real tough out in the NCAA tournament. My most disappointing team of the season is, no question, North Carolina State. Here's a team that entered the season ranked in the top 10 off of that dramatic Sweet 16 run. They brought back much of the team that made that run to the Sweet 16, and they added some very good freshmen, but they just haven't gelled, and more importantly, they haven't defended. This is a team that just wants to outscore people, and that is really a bad formula for success away from home. And since the NCAA tournament is not going to be played entirely in Raleigh, North Carolina, I do not expect North Carolina State to make a lot of noise when the madness begins. Every NCAA tournament, it seems there's one or two players who just explodes in March and takes their team on a deep tournament run. Remember how Stephen Curry took Davidson to the Elite Eight? Well, I see a couple of players out there who have the potential to do just that. We start in Omaha, Nebraska, where Doug McDermott is one of the nation's best pure scorers at Creighton. He's a 6'7" junior forward who shoots upwards of 50% from three-point range at any point in time. McDermott can go for 40, and if that happens, Creighton becomes really, really tough to beat. Marcus Smart is a freshman point guard at Oklahoma State. People who are hardcore college basketball fans understand just how good he is. I think he's the most talented basketball player in all of college basketball, impacts the game in every area. Great leader, great scorer, lots of toughness, lots of character. He makes Oklahoma State a real tough matchup when he's making his outside shot. And finally, if South Dakota State gets back to the NCAA tournament, look for Nate Walters to take the Jackrabbits, maybe to a win or two that would surprise some people. Walters is one of these guys who is a point guard. He's a big scorer. A lot of people key on him, but he can still put up a lot of points. He's a very dynamic player, and he's the kind of guy who can get a lot of points without disrupting what his team does. So Nate Walters, Marcus Smart, and Doug McDermott, maybe one of those three, will be this year's Stephen Curry. There was a remarkable occurrence early in last year's NCAA tournament when not one but two number two seeds lost in the first round. Duke and Missouri went down within a few hours of each other. Who are the highly rated teams that are most likely to go out early this year? Well, I've got three for you. First of all, Syracuse. The Orange have won a lot of games, but I just don't trust their guards, Michael Carter-Williams and Brandon Trish. They don't shoot the ball well, and I don't think that they are as strong on the interior in terms of that zone defense as they have been in the past. If they don't make shots, they're liable to lose. Arizona is another team to me that has underachieved a little bit this season. They're not very good defensively, especially out on the perimeter, and I just don't think using Mark Lyons, who's always been a scorer all of his life, as your primary point guard, ball handler, and decision maker, has worked well for them during the Pac-12 regular season, especially over the last few weeks, and I don't think that having a questionable point guard is a good way to go into the NCAA tournament. And finally, Florida. I know that Florida is a very good defensive team, but if you look at what they did in the SEC season, they had a hard time winning on the road. Why? Too dependent on the outside shot. I know that they had some injury issues without Will Yeget, so certainly getting him back will help. But I have to be honest, I like Kenny Boynton. I think he's a good player, but I think at the end of the day, I don't have a lot of faith in his ability to make a good decision down the stretch or make a clutch shot. His three-point shooting has really gone down over the last few weeks. So Florida, Arizona, and Syracuse. If you're looking for teams to pick against in the early rounds, those are my top three candidates.